Hello there. Good morning, watching Proactive London. Alastair Riddell is joining us here from Nuformix because you have announced some positive news regarding the data on NXP002. This is your preclinical lead asset and a potential novel inhaled treatment for idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, otherwise known as IPF. So, Alastair, good to see you. Take us through this news.
Yes, I mean, it comes in several parts, really. First of all, on the formulation of the product and the ability to make it soluble. Secondly, in how we deliver it into the lungs via nebulizers. And thirdly, the studies we've been doing both in vivo and in vitro to demonstrate the effect of the drug. So if we go up to the formulation, the original molecule tatranolast is actually quite insoluble. It's also limited in its indications to various regions in Japan, China, and Korea. Because of the solubility issue. The new sorts that Nuformix scientists have developed are now very soluble, and importantly, in solution, are stable over several months. This stable solution can be delivered via standard nebulizers, both mains-driven and battery-driven nebulizers. So this will not be novel for patients who require nebulized inhalation. The studies we've done in animals have demonstrated that this nebulized formulation can be effectively delivered to the lungs and deliver therapeutically doses to the lungs that reduce inflammatory cells in reactions in those lungs. We've also demonstrated that this response, when you look at inflammatory cells in isolation in vitro, is dose dependent. And that's very important in all pharmacological studies to show a dose-dependent reaction. All of this demonstrates, I think, that we have something that is now able to become a real pharmaceutical. Earlier studies that we also mentioned in the RNS yesterday have shown that the product is effective in reducing inflammatory mediators in the lungs explanted from IPF patients. And this is really quite important. So we have, I think, a really good solid data set that is convincing, certainly to the board, that this drug is worth taking forward. So what we're going to do now is to look at the plans to get this product phase one ready over the next 12 months. We've also discovered during the studies that we've been doing some interesting data that we may be able to lead to expanding our patent estate on this. This, of course, obviously builds value into the product. So the work we're going to do to make this phase one ready will be formal tox studies, we'll be developing manufacturing processes and doing any final tweaks necessary on the formulation. We hope to be phase one ready by the end of next year. Because the board is now much more confident in what the product can offer, we will be obviously investing more in further studies and in the human resource in the company to take the company forward.
In your last interview here at Proactive, you talked about receiving the full data set in early 2022. Is this still the case now that you've announced these?
Yes, indeed. What we've shown so far is that the product can be delivered, it has an effect, and the effect is certainly what we would like to see in the inflammatory cells. The studies that are still underway are to look at the duration of effect in an inflammatory challenge model. And because of the pressure on slots in the contract research organizations that Anne spoke about in the last interview, we won't be able to complete those tests probably until January, but these are going ahead and we expect to be able to announce results early next year. And nothing we've seen so far indicates that there will be a difficulty with that, but we need to do the data to feel confident.
Mm-hmm. And what will be your plans for NXF002 should you receive further positive data?
Well, as I said before, I think this really does give the board confidence that this is a product worth investing in, and I think that will become very interesting to the industry. And just to remind everyone, IPF is a rare disease, but a serious disease, as serious as cancer in terms of mortality. Mm-hmm. And this means that, first of all, that drugs entering into it get orphan drug status, which is quite important from a marketing point of view. And the two existing drugs for IPF, pirfenidone and nintedanib, made by Roche and Boehringer Ingelheim, respectively, have annual sales in excess of $2.5 billion. So this is a really commercially interesting opportunity. One of the things we will be also looking at is how our drug interacts with those existing drugs, because I think there could be some really interesting possibilities there. And just like cancer, one drug alone often isn't enough, and you often need to have a cocktail of drugs. So this is something we will be looking at in the future too.
Alastair Riddell, thank you so much indeed from Nuformix here on Proactive London today.
Thank you, Katie.